Why do people come here?
They want to know about the Jamaican history, the heritage, and they want to know about the geological features of Jamaica. Not to mention how they survived the cave, yep, and the habitats that live within that are important to our ecosystem and the environment.
In the Caribbean, there's lots of places to go, but there's something unique about Jamaica that I can't quite put my finger on, and you guys talk a lot about it. What is it?
It has a lot to do with the people. It's all about the people, the culture, the music, the lifestyles. We have a mixture of various races, like from Africa, North, South America, and Asia, cultural background, cultural mix, and all cultures bring their parts of their world to Jamaica, making a blending pot. Mm-hmm. And at the same time, we are like a laid-back group of people that enjoys life to the fullest.
Why do these caves exist?
It was created beneath the sea, roughly by a combination of dead aquatic life. And then what is believed is that a volcano beneath Jamaica is what shifted the tectonic plates and forcing the massive cave from under the sea. Mm-hmm. And it became a hideout for many generations of people, mm-hmm, and now an attraction today.
How long does it take to go through them?
It's about a 45-minute tour.
That's it, so pretty easy.
It's pretty easy.
And where are we, by the way?
We're now in Discovery Bay, St. Anne, Jamaica.
St. Anne, which is between Montego Bay and where are we on the north coast?
We are very close to Trelawney.
Got it.
Close to the Trelawney Cruise Ship Pier. Trelawney is also close to Montego Bay. And we're about half an hour towards Ocherius.
Well, let's go take a look, man.
Why not?
Jamaican history has a unique story to it, doesn't it?
That is true. Columbus was told by Cubans they were the land of gold. So his arrival in Jamaica was actually for riches.
This is 1494?
1494. But eventually the Tainos, they thought the Spaniards were gods, offered hospitality, but then they became slaves. So that led to the Spanish taking over in 1509, so we became Santiago.
Right.
And what the Spaniards did in Jamaica, it was a storage facility at first. When they realized the agricultural background, it's good, the soil is good, it's fertile. So they started to do banana in 1510, didn't do well. So they brought the West Africans in 1517 and do sugar plantation business.
Why didn't the bananas do well?
Because you find banana takes a long time to produce.
Got it.
Sugarcane is more quicker, and you can do a lot more sugarcane, yep, than banana. And plus, it makes rum.
Right.
Rum was like a big deal, right, you know?
Do they get a little claustrophobic?
There are areas where the space is a little narrow, but it's not really a claustrophobic feeling because there's a lot of ventilation, natural ventilation within the caves. But what if I tell you that this was a part of a James Bond film by the name of Live and Let Die?
Oh, yeah.
So they shot the final scenes of him being chased through this cave. Mm-hmm. And then when I take you to the depths of the Green Gutter Lake, that's where they did the final part of the movie.
How long did Ian Fleming live here? Did he live here full time?
He lived there full time. I think he was a part of the military, mm-hmm, of England. But he fell in love with Jamaica, and he started his first James Bond year, Dr. No,
Dr. No.
Sean Connery.
What do people, when they come in for the first time, what do you see? What do they say?
Many people, as they enter the cave, they're in awe. Yeah. They're like, entering this light into a world of its own. It is amazing, it is spacious, and they're like, they're seeing the habitat movements of the bats. But there's some parts of the cave you can just be extremely quiet. Mm-hmm. Listen to the flow, the dripping of water, bloop, the sound of the bats. The animal life. It's a very different feeling you get when you're inside this cave. All of this structure here was a part of an 80s nightclub. They had a nightclub inside the caves.
Oh, you're kidding me.
I'm serious.
That's cool.
So we clean the caves of any garbage. Mm-hmm. We don't kill trees, don't burn bushes, mm-hmm, sensor lights. They only come on when there's a tour.
Mm-hmm. How many people go through here a day?
It can be up to maybe 1,000 people or maybe 500. On a cruise day, on an average day, maybe like 200 people.
Got it.
People hid inside the cave, African ancestors, Taino Indians of South America, Spaniards, even pirates, once used as a safe haven. You see, the English, they came in 1655, May 10. Mm-hmm. General Robert Van Nebels, Admiral William Penn's army. But one particular man was here, Cristobal Arnalbo Assasi. Please watch your head. He was the last Spanish governor of the island of Jamaica. His idea was to do this, hide out in this cave until he gets an opportunity to escape. And surprisingly, there's a passage he used to go 3 miles out to an exit on the beach, located a boat, and use it to go 90 miles to our neighbor Cuba. And that passage is on your right.
Oh, wow.
That's what we call today the escape route. The system of the cave is actually two caves. There is the current one you're in by the name of Runaway Caves. Mm-hmm. It was named after the African ancestors, primarily used by them as a secret hideout until they had the opportunity to flee to the hills. They were known as people of the hills, so they tried to go to the hills, create their villages, mm-hmm. create their armies to rebel against the English. However, the cave after this is the popular known Green Grotto. Watch your head. Which greenery has to do with a color on the rocks. Two types of things on the rocks, oxidized copper and the water plant algae. Grotto is Latin meaning cave with underground water. And in fact, if both caves are joined together, it goes 10 miles in length, 28 square miles in width. It's like a hidden secret revealed.
When they come for the first time, what do people, they get inside these caves, what do they say to you?
They are amazed, they're in awe, they fall in love. Coming here gives you an experience of the past, let you realize that ancestors have been through, where they used to hide, what they used to do, and how useful the cave was for them. Green Grotto Cave is a 40 feet depth cave. 40 feet. And they go as far as creating some steps to help you to access this cave. For the ancestors, they use roots. We are now in the Green Grotto Cave. You're in that cave where the lake system, combination of salt and fresh, 19 feet, 6 meters depth, 15 degrees Celsius, 60 Fahrenheit.
Now, people can't get in this water, though, when they come to visit, right?
Well, they used to, but what you're looking into now is that there's a lot of bats living above the lake, so it wouldn't be safe for people to jump in.
So there are bats above us right now?
Yes, there are bats
above
us right now. Now, if I could look carefully, I might be able to find something. Ah, right there.
Look at those guys.
Right there.
Oh, they don't like the light.
No, they are nocturnal, like the Batman himself, right?
Uh-huh. This is awesome. Chen, good to meet you, man.